I found this video in called like Art Support. Pretty much it has like X, all the sayings that X used to say. X was very like pro self, like self mastery, because he really like mastered. He didn't really master himself, but he was like, I'm evolving fast. All right, you're talking about the sins of who I was before, not the sins of who I am right now, and constantly changing. I'm always changing.
Let me be on probation, put it, run it concurrent or some shit, you know what I'm saying? Let me be on probation, monitor me, and see what I turn into. And if I'm about my word, I'm going to turn into what I said I'm going to turn into.
Dang, he said that like 4 years ago. Oh, well, after he died, the media was like, he still did these things, but let's put him on a billboard or Spotify. Spotify back then was like, let's get rid of X music on there. Oh, yeah, let's get rid of X music on here. But then afterwards, yo, he got a billion streams on Spotify.
As far as creation, being creative in thought, being like living life like a dream. If you believe in something, you can achieve it. You are
manifestation
in your own movie.
Get the magic key. No, not magic key. Master's key.
You desire to be. Like, I'm not going to come on your tour and not leave my mark.
Something like that.
Respected through love rather than fear. Mine is but a magnet to what you want. Only you create your purpose. Mm-hmm. To make sure you are being healthy in mind, being caring, compromising for the ones you love.
Rest in peace, Jase. Yeah, they do this for a lot of other artists too. I may do that, I don't know. Like once a week, just do like react to like some quotes.
Everybody feels like there's a standard you have to meet. Everybody feels like, oh, you got to follow the rules. I'm not that type of guy.
True.
Like, I'm not going to come on your tour and not leave my mark. I'm not going to go to this different city and not leave my mark. Whether it's by me doing some crazy shit, whether it's by me speaking the right words, whether it's by me doing something I was supposed to.
Speaking the right words.
I'm not going to go anywhere without leaving my mark. It's better to be respected through love rather than fear. It's better to be respected through, not to repeat myself. It's better to be respected through love rather than fear. Simply because
love is more powerful.
Fear,
he knows this. He really knew all of this. Like he knew he knows love is more powerful than fear. He knows about like the right person having the right energy saying the right stuff is 10 times more impactful than just like somebody else saying the same stuff. Like you have to be the right person with the right energy, and something just like he said, something crazy will happen.
And it drives people away. It makes people treat you differently.
It'll feel a lot more.
Really, like, it's just not genuine. It's not what you really would want. So, like I said, anything that made me feel like a slave, I wasn't with it. Our skin color has long evolved from that. You know what I'm saying? And now it's bigger than just our skin color. That's what I want people to also see.
It's an economic war right now.
Not even just that. Like, mentally, the slavery is not physical.
Spiritual warfare. Spiritual warfare out here. I got to be careful I give my energy to.
You know what I'm saying?
You don't get energy to those people.
I love Lil Pump. Bro, before him and his little homeboy got on, I'm not even going to say his name. I'm not giving nobody no power. You don't say it either.
To apply it to. The mind is but a magnet to what you want. You know what I'm saying? A law of attraction, like all the laws of the universe I studied.
Laws in the universe. Study laws in the universe. Laws in the universe. The master key.
Like, I feel like the younger you are, or when you put a topic on your, well, you put a pin on your age, it's like putting a pin on your knowledge.
Yeah.
So if you don't know how old I am, you know I could be 35. For all you know, I could be fucking 15.
True.
For all you know, I could be 19, 18, 16. You feel me? Like, the older, I feel like the older
Is this why TQ say he was 300?
When
he was like 16, but he was like, I'm 300. Because you don't want to be talked down. Because he already accomplished so much at that age. He accomplished so much, experienced so much stuff at that age. He don't want to be talked down on. Damn, TQ. Damn. Okay.
Telling a nigga I'm this age.
That's how this man was so special. Like, oh, yeah, this makes you, I don't know. Exactly.
I've been in the game longer. Like, I've been through more. So I don't like to put a pin on my age, because it's like putting a pin on my knowledge. So I just tell niggas I'm 300.
Okay, so my current focus.
Oh, you just said 300, just like TP. Okay.
Whether you realize it or not, every day you evolve. Every day you create.
So TP knew that too.
You evolute in mind. You evolute as far as your age. You evolute physically, mentally.
Mm-hmm.
If you are evoluting physically and you are not evoluting mentally, you are not doing the right thing. So for you guys, I want you guys to constantly be trying to evolve as far as creation, being creative in thought, being like living life like a dream, you know, like as far as you are the actor in your own movie. You get what I'm saying? And you are the person that you desire to be. If you want to be, pretend to be a princess, carry yourself with the mannerisms of a princess. If you want to
be. But then it's also like, see, that's the thing. Like, I feel like he stops right there with the self, but it's also a self relationship with the world too. Like, if you act like you're a princess, but the world treats you not like a princess, it's going to be contradiction right there. Your relationship with the world matters too. Unless you're so confident in yourself of being, I think that's what he will probably do it. Like, unless you're so confident in you being yourself that you are a princess, you are one. And then the world will have to accept that. And it would be like that. So it wouldn't be, but you have to be that confident. And a lot of people are not that confident. And the world will move? Maybe, I don't know.
Carry yourself with the mannerism of a prince. No one can explain
probably. The world will move.
You
probably.
Are alive. No one can save you but you. You have to put the mind into what you want to put the mind into. If you believe in something, you can achieve it. Now, that doesn't mean everybody needs to be a rapper. That
Facts.
Does not mean
that's only entertaining.
Needs to be a fucking painter or an artist. That doesn't mean that way. Your art can be in your emotion. Your art can be in your mind. Now, you can be a doctor, and that can be a form of art.
True. Exactly.
As far as my persona, I mean, I go from...
You can wash the dishes, and that could be art. Sweep the floor, that could be art. Just stroke by stroke.
Saying the wrong right things.
You do washing windows.
Loud way. Then I'll go to like literally saying nothing and being very scarce with my words and saying very little and it meaning a lot. So like, as far as my persona, like, it's everything to me. I guess you could say like literally everything to me, because without a persona, you're nobody. If you don't have a personality, you're nothing. I'm still a real person. I still have emotions. I still
You're something.
Out of character.
You're something. If you don't have a persona, that's you losing your sense of self. You're still something. I feel like that's what a lot of I won't say gurus, but they lose the sense of self. The thinker and the thought are both thoughts. They're both pretty much not non-existent, really. You lose your sense of self, you'll find really like what you are. Like, you're something. I still feel like you're something.
The bit like getting into character and be creating this artist is literally like the death of my name, my real name, or the death of my government name, or the death of who I was. It's like becoming an artist, you have to abandon everything. You just have to become this totally different character. So the more I turn into that, is the less I give a fuck about anything going on around me.
Only you create your purpose. Now, trying to always impress others does not work. Now, with
I don't remember him saying none of this, bro. I mean, this happened years ago. Fans and I was in a different mind state back then. It just went right over my head. Now I'm listening to it differently.
Will hit me up and be mad disappointed with some decisions I made, be mad disappointed with some music, and I've tried my best to impress or meet this standard, you know?
You don't need to meet that standard.
Fuck that.
You're the artist.
Make yourself happy. If something makes you happy, follow it. Now, do not be toxic.
You're the artist.
Do not take my words and twist them and turn them negative. Purpose. No one can create your purpose for you. No one can tell you who to be. There is no such thing. Well, sorry. There is no such thing. No one can tell you who to be. So in purpose, you have to create your own purpose. And in evolution, you have to evolute towards that purpose. It's easier to live when you have goals to meet. You understand?
True.
If you have goals to meet, then you don't feel so voided, and you understand why every day you're looking at this person in the mirror. Because that is the cool part about the game. You get to be anybody you want to be.
Bro, this man is spitting, bro. What he say this, bro? What he say this? I don't, bro, when he say, bro. Cause I know I watched that video back then. I watched all of this. I watched this. I watched everything. He was my favorite artist back then.
Equality. Everybody wants equality. And then they try and make this black power make equality a whole different privilege. You cannot be privileged. There is no privilege in equality. So you can't. So if a fucking asshole comes and arrests you, and you think that cops are just all racist, cops violate.
But you gotta know,
if
like,
if you were white, you were gonna be white. If you were black, you were gonna.
But
be
you gotta
black.
Like what Malcolm X said. You get stabbed. What Malcolm X was saying in that saying, it is privilege when you get stabbed. Like 9 inches in your back, you have to pull it out, and then you have to mend the wound. The mending the wound is like adding aid to it, pretty much. Like you just take it out, and then be like, "Bro, we're equal." He still has a stab wound in his back. You have to aid it, and that in a sense that is privilege. So I disagree with that. Then, yeah, I disagree with that. But then what do you say? You're like, America is not. They don't even say there's a knife. They don't even say there's a knife in America. Like the knife's not there in America.
If that cop fucking hates black people, then you just so happen to get the hard end of the stick. You feel me? But
so I feel like okay, they do need to be some privilege. You gotta aid the wound.
They do need to be some privilege
to have equality.
The key to love is compromise. The key to love is also loving yourself. Now, and love is a very complicated thing. Look at love like a game. Everything is a game. Look at love like a game.
I disagree with that too.
For your partner to
I think love is just a feeling. I don't want to look at it as a game. It's just a feeling. Just look at it as a feeling.
For them. So it's a very complicated idea. To make sure you are being healthy in mind, being caring, compromising for the ones you love, being loyal to the ones you love. Do not say you love me and be some motherfucker out here cheating on your people. Look, if you love someone, you're supposed to be dedicated to them, right?
He has way more quotes than this, though. I know he has way more quotes than this. X was literally a 101. X was a 101, bro. I want to have a conversation with that man. I mean, he'd be, what, 24? So when he was that age, I was like 15, 16, 25. I don't know how old he'd be. Dang. I'd like to have a conversation with him. Like, he's a generational talent, man. He's a generational talent, too.